Going to be going off to work here pretty soon and out for another few weeks, so I thought I'd give you guys at least a status update and let you know what I was up to and where the bike was at. Fuel tank is just sitting there and the seat is just sitting there just for aesthetics reasons. I just missed the bike, but from head to toe I'll tell you where I'm at with the bike and what I've done up till now. Just a lot of little bits going back together, and I might as well just start right from the beginning. Everything's torqued down on the front end except for the brake lines aren't done yet, so the master cylinder doesn't have any brake fluid in it. All the electrical in the headlight is complete. The crossover tube has been tested. I put my little ringies back up in here. The cable for the choke is on this side. Horns are missing, so they still gotta be put on. They work. The caps are all complete. All the new O-rings have been installed and the caps have been torqued. I got a great new tool for that. The exhaust system is just hanging here because I wanted to wait for the new gaskets. I got the ones up in the top, but I don't have the ones that mate down near the muffler. You notice the starter's still missing. I checked it out. My starter's grinding when I engage it. So I've got a new starter on order. Solenoid I'm gonna keep. All the new wiring, I'm gonna replace all the wiring and everything. The solenoid looks pretty bare here, but I've got all new seals. And you can look inside there. There's a seal missing there. There's a seal missing where the shifter is. There's a seal missing where the clutch goes. So there's three seals, I think, on this side. Yeah, three on this side, one on the other. The other one is actually a spinning shaft, so it's a different seal. These ones are all metric, and I got those on order, so they were coming. I've replaced all of the vacuum lines except for the one that goes up to the boost sensor, but it's all connected. The boost sensor wiring is all, or the boost, yeah, the boost sensor wiring and the boost sensor vacuum hose is right there. So that's in. The coils are sitting here ready to go. And that's the coil wire for the front. I'll show you the one in the back here in a minute. These covers are just on here loosely. I still have to put the alternator and the little pickup coil in there, and that'll have all the wires come out on this side. Obviously no foot pegs on this side, but they have been overhauled, and I'll show you that here in a second. Everything's been cleaned up real nice. The exhaust system in the back again is just in loose, but like I mentioned, all of the O-rings for the caps, for the valve covers, the O-rings for here are in as well. I'll put those sizes up so you guys know what they are. The little fittings are in, the little rubber spacers for vibration control are in. This is just a breather tube and it's the original one. And that was in really good shape, so I just left that as it is. Most of the wiring is complete. There's a few things that need to be tidied up and they're just sitting here kind of at random, doing nothing, like the side stand switch. And I just have it plugged in for testing reasons, but side stand still has to go on. And of course, all of the brackets and everything for the left side foot pegs and shifter control, they'll go on as well. Battery box is in, but the fuel tank is not. And that's the fuel filter line that goes over to the pump. For the inlet for the pump, it'll come up the bottom side of the secondary fuel tank. And all these fuel lines are new. Fuel filter's new. That's all cleaned up. That's the muffler, it's all cleaned up. You guys saw me working on this quite a while ago. And I went nuts on that, of course. The foot pegs have all been restored nicely. I filed all the scratches out of them and then polished them on the polishing wheel. A little harder than the aluminum, but same process, and it looks really good. As you can see, the aluminum turned out really well. What else is over here? Oh yeah, the shock absorber bolts are torqued as well. This nut is torqued with a cotter pin. Nice little fancy cotter pin. The tire, of course. I didn't mention this before, but it's a 150-90-15, which is one size over. And I had that same size on my Virago that I had back in 84, identical to this. And I really loved the look. Just a little bit wider. It will be a little bit taller. That slightly taller tire will lower the RPM at highway speeds just a little bit, maybe by about 100 or 200 RPM. The key has been installed, the key lock. Signal lights have been installed and they're all functioning nicely. The backrest I got from Mike Success, the same place where I got the seat cover. This is an 1100 seat with the double buttons, and the 1000 for 84 and 85 just had a single row of buttons. They all had that same pad in the back. That's all done. All right, everything back here looks pretty good. The taillight assembly, of course, I polished all this stuff. All the plastic chrome came out. It's really durable, a lot more durable than what I expected it to be. Let's see, the headlight and the speedo and the tack are all that high impact plastic that's chrome plated. So I don't know what process they use, but it works really well. The toolbox has been reinstalled, all cleaned up, polished on the wheel, same way. Everything works. My little kit's back in there as well. All of the aluminum that I've polished up looks amazing. I'm so pleased with the way that turned out. I was a little iffy about it at first. As you can see, I've got the new backrest cover installed. The innards are all OEM. It's all the original bike. The Virago decal was in good shape, so I just cleaned it up. All of those little caps that are little plastic chrome caps that go over the bolts, I had those and I just cleaned them up. They're original, the old ones. It looks pretty good. All right, not as much room on this side to move around, so I think what else? And the lighting's not the greatest either, but on this side, there's not much difference. Battery's still not installed. I've been charging it here and there as I need it. This is the new piece that I got off eBay. Mine was cracked from the fall over. And same thing here. This one was damaged pretty bad. So it took a lot of work. Again, just sanded it and filed it first and then sanded it and then put it on the polishing wheel and just used the heavier compounds. The aluminum looks great. The hardware looks great. The muffler looks great. I got this dent. And I'm thinking what I might do is I might drill a hole on the other side and pound it out and then weld the hole up. We'll see how that turns out. If not, I might take this cap off. I'll have to cut it off, repair it, and then put it back on. And then if that doesn't work, then the only other alternative is to find a stock exhaust system, which is really hard these days. These have all been oiled and cleaned. Got everything nicely lubricated inside, all the springs and everything. So they go straight out. Everything's been adjusted and repaired. They look wonderful. The fuel pump is in, but it's kind of temporary for now. I just wanted to get the lines run, and I wanted especially that one that comes from the high pressure one that goes back up to the carburetors that runs up along the top. Just runs inside this little plastic cap. That's the back spark plug wire. New breather hose, which is just clear. It's kind of like clear vinyl tubing, I think is what the other stuff was. The inlets are still not on. I haven't put those on yet. This side cover is still just kind of loose. The clutch has been taken apart. I'm waiting for clutch plates and clutch springs. They're coming shortly. That's the rear brake. That's just a mounting bracket. I got oil filters. I've got O-rings. I got seals. There's one on this side that actually comes out the crankcase. And there's a channel inside here. And it routes the oil from the crankcase back up to these points right here and then drives those up. So that's the seal that's really important on the other side. It's a spinning seal. It's slightly different than the rest. And that's all I got to do for this side. And then, of course, I got new gaskets. I got to clean that up before I put it on. The two gaskets that I'm waiting for fit down here for the exhaust. But that's that new pipe. It looks really good. The side covers look great. All the O-rings have been reinstalled, all new O-rings in here. And they're, I'll throw the size up. I don't remember off the top of my head. And like I said, the valve cover caps have all been torqued. What else on this side? The brakes are still yet to be completed. Everything's overhauled, of course. I did that before I did the rebuild. But these hoses are all brand new. They're custom made. and I supplied this wire. It cost me a lot of money, a couple hundred bucks to have these made, but this looks great. I still have to trim this off to make it the right, I don't know, it just has to be opened up a little bit, but I put too much on there on purpose so that I could cut it and stretch it and make it look like it did with the original stuff. And this looks fantastic. This looks really, really good. Of course, all of the signal lights are brand new. One brand new stem, it was broken. And the rest are all original. Everything's been cleaned up. Like I said, this is yet to be torqued. And I don't think there's anything else on this side. I have the original emblems that I bought. And the tank, let's talk about the tank real quick before I sign off. I polished the tank and it looks really good. Now, the whole plan was to repaint it, but I've got two dents here and another one up there and a couple of stone chips. It was minor, but after I polished it, it actually looks really good. And I'm thinking I might keep that as it is. But if you want, guys, I don't usually ask for comments or subscribers or likes or anything like that, but if you guys want to comment as to your personal feelings about having this gas tank repainted, I'm just going to, if I was going to do it, it would be just this color here. And it happens to be the identical to House of Colors, the Brandywine candy. It's a lot, it's really hard to paint, it's very expensive, but the plan would be to leave this color here, which is slightly different, leave this mask over all of this, just redo the brandy and then put a clear over top of everything. Or option two is just leave it as it is and keep the gas tank original, because it does look really good now that I've polished it. And of course the gas cap turned out great. Coming up here to the handlebars, got the original grips. These are not the original end caps, but I have, you know, my overhauled grips, my levers are back to looking fresh and new again. The throttle cable has been hooked up, and let's see, gauges, of course I talked about those, the choke cable I already mentioned, and the grip over here on the left side. These are actually Honda grips, which was kind of weird, but they were all the same back then. Even the CB650 custom from 1980, I think, had, it's the first time I saw these, but all the bikes had them, so I didn't want to spend $28 on a set of grips from Yamaha when they were, I think, $7 or $8 from Honda. Up front here, I've got a new decal on the ignition. I've got the caps still for these to go in. I gotta clean those up. I have the original little tie wraps that Yamaha had on here, and I've got four of them that I got from CMSNL in Holland. And that's it. I think there's, like I said, there's still quite a bit of work to do. A lot of things to finish up, a lot of things to clear up. The bike's looking really good. It's such a nice looking bike. I just love the colors and love everything about it. And you know, having it fresh and new is gonna be pretty cool. Now, there's not a lot of them in this kind of shape. What else after that? That's closed up. The fuel tank can go in after that. I have new hoses. There's the hoses. Yeah, so they'll go in there. So she's coming along. Like I said, a few things still have to come off before I can finish it up. And of course, the last things that'll go on would be all of the vacuum stuff and the air filter and stuff like that. And then it'll be time to fill it full of oil, fill it full of gas, and get it started. Anyway, I just wanted to give you guys an update. Didn't want to leave you hanging, and I like to put out a video at least every 3 weeks or so. It's a cycle that I work at. So anyway, that's it. Stay tuned for more. I got a lot of really cool stuff coming. This thing's gonna be back to a running state here pretty soon. Hope so anyway. All right. Cheers.